morning, guys. Today I am doing a day in the life of a first-year engineering student at McMaster University. I picked Tuesday because Tuesdays are a very average representation of any one of my days throughout the week. Tuesdays are like typical 5 hours of class. Mondays I have like three. Wednesdays I have seven, so it really, you know, varies. So Tuesdays is a very like average number of hours of class that I'll have. So I was gonna show you my tasks and stuff, and I will, but I got a really exciting email from a professor that I emailed about co-op this summer, and she actually wants to meet with me this Thursday, which is really exciting.
Okay, let's show you my tasks. So I use Google Task, and it's great for keeping track of everything I have to do. Here is my current list of tasks. And this is actually quite short compared to what it was last week, because I should probably explain, we just finished midterms, like our second round of midterms. So at McMaster, we have two rounds of midterms. We finished our second round on Friday. I had my last one on Friday, which was absolutely terrible. Anyways, that's the only reason I have time to vlog today, because I'm done midterms. This to-do list is quite short considering that it's not midterm season, but I still have a lot to do. A lot of it is catching up, because during midterms I neglect all the other courses that I don't have, like that I've already done midterms for. So econ, haven't watched a single video for that class since the midterm, and same thing with chemistry, I haven't been going to lectures. Yeah, I'm very behind. Okay, so I'm just gonna put in a thing for a meeting with the professor. We're gonna delete chemistry because I don't go to that class, which you'll see later today. I'm not gonna go to the chemistry. I'm just gonna add like meeting. Okay, so I'm about to leave for class, but I kind of just like to figure out what I'm doing for the day. So we're Tuesday right now, I have math at 8:30, and then I do have chemistry at 10:30, but I never go to this class because I just watch the lectures online. So I have this 3-hour block. I believe I'm going to go to physics help to get some of my physics questions answered, and then I might come back to my room to study, go to physics, and then yeah. So that is the plan. We gotta go, otherwise I'm going to be late for class. It's 8:15.
First year engineering.
And hi, I'm Lydia, and I'm also in first year engineering.
You probably already saw Lydia in the first day of school vlog, which will be posted soon. Yeah, we're all in the same program. We are in math class, as you can see. Integration techniques. Fun time. Amina's going to
Thode.
Lydia's going to physics.
I'm going to my physics class.
And I'm going to physics help to get help because I didn't understand two of my long kappa. Or like, I thought I understood them, but I got the wrong answer. So I think it's like an algebra mistake. So I'm going to ask them to check. After that, I'm going back to res to like study. And then I have physics at 12:30. Currently 10:45 and I'm headed back to my dorm. I'm a little behind schedule, but I needed the help with physics. This is the favorite part of campus for me to walk through. I always walk through this part if I can instead of going the other way because it's just nice. There's lots of trees here. But yeah, I'm gonna head back to my room and work on probably econ or chemistry, one of the two, and then I have physics class later. I'm back in my room and I'm going to work on econ because I didn't get to it at all this weekend, which is kind of a problem. So basically I'm behind in econ because after the midterm I basically didn't watch any of the lecture videos. So this course is blended, so it's half online, half in person. I would say it's more like 80% online, 20% in person. We have one lecture a week, but then we have like 4 hours of video, or like 2 hours of video, 2 to 3 hours of video to watch each week. I haven't been watching the videos nor attending the lectures because I've been studying for my other midterms, hence I'm very behind in this course. So I'm going to try to catch up on videos. I'm about 4 hours behind on videos, like 2 weeks behind. So we're gonna try to get through this chapter, chapter 9 on Monopoly. Making some notes right now, but yeah, I've got about an hour and 15 minutes to do that, so hopefully I can finish chapter 9 and then still very behind, but it'll be something. It is time for a snack. I always eat before my physics class because my physics class is at 12:30. I always get super hungry because I don't get to eat lunch till 1:30, so I always eat like a snack, usually like a fruit plus either like crackers or cheese, something like that.
This is the green box that I'm gonna need after physics for lunch.
Crispy, crispy chicken. What does that say?
With cheese.
Nice.
Yes.
And there's Madison. I'm going to Centro. We're going to Centro to get my typical lunch, which I literally like. It's very typical because I get it every single day, so it doesn't change. I get simple every day. Just wanted to say, the clips you saw in physics, we were trying to express typically how we do on these iClicker questions, because like we never get them right. Today we got more right than usual, so that was very exciting. So that wasn't typical, but basically we never get them right.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
You too.
Look at this studious student. Okay, this is my meal. This is cauliflower steak, because they like to call things that are not steak, steak. And then quinoa and vegetables. I get the same thing literally every day, so this is very typical. It's not the same thing, it's from the same place, simple. And then they change up their meals every day. I think I already talked about this in the first day of school vlog, so I don't need to repeat myself, but their meals are really good.
So we are house hunting.
House hunting is not typical, but Madison and I are, no, we're not desperate for a house. I mean, we do need a house for next year. And so this house we're looking at is for 8 people. Our situation right now is kind of, we have
five,
like for sure. 5 of us, and then like maybe 2 more. We don't know yet. Housing is a problem for us first years because we don't know what we're doing. So we don't even know if this email is like correct. Like, okay, this is what I wrote. Hi there. Myself and a group of friends are interested in this house. When would be a good time to see it? Is this how you send an email to see a house? I don't know. We'll find out. We are heading to 2 different classes. I'm going to my physics tutorial, which is my last tutorial of the semester, which is really exciting. Or last one for physics. Madison is going to fun time. Okay, this route is not very typical, but we took it because there's less people so that we could vlog without being judged. So that's why. But we usually, like, I usually go through the student center if it's cold, or I'll go like around DBAC, or not around DBAC, but like DBAC and then right if I'm going to MDCL, which is where I'm headed. She's headed to,
I just say we are doing this tutorial, and we learned angular momentum today, and we're doing our tutorial on it. Whatever, it's fine.
So I'm back from my physics tutorial, my last one of the semester, and I realized I made such a stupid mistake on the quiz at the end. So basically we have a quiz at the end of each tutorial. I think it's worth like 1% of our final grade, so it's really not a lot, so I'm not gonna like stress over it. But I knew something was up when I was the first one to finish. I'm never the first one to finish. I handed it in because I was like, whatever, I'll go back early and do some more work. If I can hand it in early, I can leave early. So I handed it in, and then I checked my notes because the question we get for the quiz is like the same as one of the long Kappa questions, just with different numbers. And then I checked that same question, and I realized I'm so stupid because I forgot to take into account the fact that it was in two dimensions, so then the object moved south instead of just continuing with the same direction. Hopefully I can get like part marks, like 2 out of 3. My process was like correct. I just forgot to take into account that it was in 2D instead of 1D. I'm so stupid. Anyways, whatever. I'm gonna get some work done again. It's currently 4:20. I got back early, as I said. It usually ends at 4:20. So I'm going to work on math, I think, because I really need to get math done. I'm gonna finish econ first. Currently 5:15. I just finished chapter 9 of econ and I have exactly 30 minutes left to do some of my math assignment before I head to DECA at 5:45 because DECA is at 6 o'clock. If anyone's curious, this is what our math assignments look like. We have one every week pretty much, and it's just about, I think it's like 8 to 10 questions. Like this week is 9 questions, and each assignment is worth 2% of our overall mark. Way to DECA. I'm gonna be there right at 6, so I'll be too late. Currently 6:50 and my DECA meeting finished a little bit early, so I am gonna head upstairs because I'm in the basement of JHE for my EWB meeting, but that got pushed to 7:15. So I'm just gonna like answer some emails, get some like work done on my laptop before meeting at 7:15. I also found out for DECA that we have to wear blazers and I don't have a blazer. So I don't have time to go buy one before Sunday, so I'm just gonna like try to borrow someone's. One of my friends hopefully has a blazer. I just got back from my DECA meeting and my Engineers Without Borders meeting. They were both pretty good meetings. DECA was quite short because it was literally just information on MDCC this coming Sunday, which is like the regionals basically for University DECA. Engineers Without Borders was a really good meeting because we had a lot of discussion about how our climate speaker panel slash discussion panel slash debate is gonna work. So we're gonna have like a climate event thing for climate change, but we were thinking of actually like instead of making it an event where a bunch of people are just agreeing with each other on climate change, we were thinking of making it so it's kind of like controversial. So invite people who, like, not necessarily climate change deniers, but people who, I don't know, an economics professor, someone who might see the other side of things, so then we can get a better understanding of why changes aren't being implemented because of economics or because of social implications, anything like that. So that was a really good meeting. We don't know the format yet of the event, but I'm really excited to see where that goes. I'm really excited to help plan that. And Madison's coming over and we're gonna work on, I don't know if we're gonna work on like physics or math. I think she wants to work on physics, but I want to work on math, so we might just end up doing like separate work. Okay, so we have a little update on the housing situation. Madison's going to explain.
Okay, so on Thursday night, we're gonna meet with Sheridan and potentially as many of her friends that can make it. And we're all gonna discuss kind of what we want in a house, I assume, and kind of just, we called a guy earlier and he said he has like lots of properties for lease. So we're gonna hopefully call him and set some dates for seeing the houses.
So it's 10:17 right now. We just finished like, it was like an hour and a half of work. Yeah, I got 4 math questions done, which doesn't sound like a lot, but I was like doing my notes as I was doing the math assignment. How much did you get done?
I don't know, like 5 questions of math. So
nice.
But again, similar thing, I'm like going through the textbook and like really like understanding the concepts yeah. and then working on the questions, so.
Yeah. Study tips from two, actually, oh, you never said what program you're in.
Oh,
what
I'm program in iBiomed, so that's biomedical engineering and health sciences.
Mm-hmm. So it's like half engineering, half health science. They can choose eng if they want next year, or they can choose health science. I think you're going with eng, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so she's going to be an engineer, just like me.
All right, so I'm able to check off this guy, and I figured out my long cap questions. But now I need to add something else because now the other long cap is due. I believe on Sunday.
Okay, so it's currently 10:30. Madison just left. I'm going to hop in the shower, brush my teeth, and go to bed, hopefully by 11 o'clock. And yeah, I'm gonna end the vlog here. So this was a typical day in my life as a first year engineering student here at McMaster University. It was quite busy, and it usually is quite busy. I'm not gonna lie, it is a lot, but I think I have chosen the right program and I enjoy most of the courses that I'm taking, with the exception of like chemistry and coding. Oh my gosh, coding. Don't even get me started on that course. Yeah, it was pretty typical. Except for house hunting, I guess. I hope you guys enjoyed this video.